I actually walk around my house like this sometimes. Just in some underwear and some boots. Let's see what we got here. Huh? Wait! Oh, I keep pressing O. I'm about to die. Woo! This guy is quick as hell, man. Tell you right now, man. If I'm fighting somebody and they're moving around like that, I'm not gonna fight. It's not gonna happen. That's crazy. This guy moves entirely too fast for a human to fight.
That doesn't sound good.
Derek the Executioner. Let's go. Yeah, I knew that was too easy.
All right, guys. Antoine Darden with Darden Digital bringing you some gameplay footage of Neo. This is going to be my first walkthrough. I am big on story and things like that, so I won't be talking through the cutscenes. But it's going to be a walkthrough and my review while playing this game. Now, I'm super excited. I've been hearing a lot of good things about the game. Everybody has said the game is pretty good. Pretty much the only criticism has been it's too hard, which is fine with me because, you know, I'm an early gamer. I've played hard games before. They're going to get it too. Obviously, all know it's been compared a lot with Dark Souls, but from the looks of it, it looks like it's going to be a little bit more story focused than Dark Souls, even though with a bit of research, you can really dig deep into Dark Souls' story. I think this one's going to be a little bit more in your face. Action mode, still the frame rate. We're gonna go with that. We're just gonna stick with that. So just right off the bat, I have looked at some gameplay of it. I have not played it myself. I didn't play any of the demos, so I am like super duper 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 fresh, super duper like first time playing it. But I have played Dark Souls, have played Bloodborne, played Demon Souls. So let's get right into it. Let's see what's going on. To the far east lies Zipangu. Lambrimer Golden Palaces and Sparkling Jewels.
Queen of England remains locked in combat. With Spain, the country where the sun never sets, for control of the entire world. Her forces weakening with every battle. The Queen and her inner circle turn to divination and alchemy, hiring pirates like us to find Enrita for them. With that power, they managed to defeat the invincible Spanish Armada. But now it seems they want to keep their methods a secret.
Kind of even got that same boom that Dark Souls had. That's pretty funny. Guys been doing his push-ups, man. Pull-ups and everything.
It seems death won't stop chasing me.
I'm just gonna jump right into it. This way, okay. Strong attack. Okay. One thing I do miss is being able to customize your character. I'm big on being able to customize characters, man. I like to look the way I want to look. But some people have been comparing this game to like Onimusha also, which is an old school PS2 game. A game that I really, really enjoyed. So I kind of, looking at it like that. Hopefully this is a good character. So, we'll see. Door seems to be locked. Okay, I'm here. Okay. I'm here. What do you want me to do? Press a strong attack, light attack. Okay, there was, oh shit, okay. I didn't know that guy was that strong, okay. It's the Hulk. Well, he hasn't been doing his push-up, so. Oh, this guy seemed better than
you. Run when I had the chance.
I guess that was.
Hey, what are you doing?
Out of here, that's what I'm doing. Or maybe not.
Wait, will you?
I'm supposed to fight this guy. Too bad. I feel like they're just taking it easy on me right now though, so I ain't gonna get too excited. So here, anything in here? Nope. Not gonna get too excited. A lot of people saying it's really hard. Can't wait to compare it and see
if it's any harder than what is this? Gondagar boots, another faster sword. Hell yeah, let's equip some weapons. Okay, pretty much the same thing, just gonna stick it on nothing. All right, gonna use our imagination. Gonna go ahead and stick that right through tighty whities. All right. I actually walk around my house like this sometimes. Just in some underwear and some boots. That's it. All right. All right, let's continue. Got a big ass bastard sword. This guy looks like he might be doing something good.
Guess yourself is your only savior.
Guard. Dodge. Okay. Okay, so you can dodge in pretty much any direction. Shortcuts. I'll probably do that a little bit later. Adjust my shortcuts and stuff. But, you know, a lot of people have been, you know, like I said, once again, comparing it to Dark Souls and things like that, saying that it's really hard. I didn't think Dark Souls and Bloodborne, and I don't really think they're that hard, to be honest with you. I just think that they aren't as easy as most of the games we're playing now. Most of the games that come out now are extremely easy. And, you know, I don't think Dark Souls makes games like that. But it's not hard at all, especially if you come from, you know, playing old school games where, you know, or even arcade games, or, you know, they were a lot more challenging. Now, I will say that those games will punish you for making mistakes. But that's pretty much the only difference. But once you learn patterns of enemies and things like that, you can pretty much master those games. And I think that's the beauty. Oh, this guy's gonna come right at me. I think that's the beauty of, you know, the Dark Souls games and the Bloodborne games and things like that. That's what makes those games so much fun and so rewarding. That's what makes them so rewarding. And, we just gonna sit back and try to shoot me. So, I hope they get my guy some pants soon. Hopefully I didn't overlook some. Cigar shirt. Like Versace or something this guy's wearing. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Huh? Wait! Oh. I keep pressing O. I'm about to die. I keep pressing the O button. I'm on PlayStation 3. I keep pressing the O button trying to, thinking this is up to Bloodborne. I gotta get out of that. It's X to dodge on the PlayStation 3. I have a lot of stamina right now. I can probably kill these guys and kill most of these guys in one flurry. And I just don't want to take that chance. At least not now. I want to learn, you know, how much how much stamina is actually gonna deplete when I use it and things like that. Let's go ahead and put my guy some pants on, man. His legs are cold. Yo, let's get some pants. Oh, that's the gloves. Okay. Here we go. All right. And I need some medicine. Let's set up some medicine. Let's see. Perfect. But again, you know, back to my point with the Dark Souls and the Blood series. You know, it's not so much that they were challenging. That they were difficult to play. It's just that they challenge you. And I think that's a great thing when it comes to video games. I think, you know, not every game needs to be like that, because sometimes you do just want to sit back and hack and slash. But, you know, it's good to have a game that's gonna challenge you. Gonna pray that everything goes well. Not really sure what that did, but okay. I have to find out later, I guess. My little spirit guy has not told me what that does. A lot of places to explore here. Melee weapon, change range weapon. I guess I would have to equip that. Let's try and go ahead and do that now. Range weapon. And I don't have one. This is my other weapon. Attack is a little bit stronger. Okay. I do like that everything is kind of streamlined. You know, just with the, almost just with the press of a button, you can pick another weapon and things like that. A lot of shortcuts. And if you're a console gamer, that means a lot.
Huh?
All right, intruder! There we go. Oh, this one takes more stamina. Okay. Now I'm nervous. Oh, this guy fell down because he's tired. Okay. Woo. This guy is quick as hell, man. God damn. Tell you right now, man. If I'm fighting somebody and they're moving around like that, I'm not gonna fight. It's not gonna happen. That's crazy. This guy moves entirely too fast for a human to fight. Which is why they got demons fighting them, I guess. But let's continue. This is gonna be bad though. I know it's gonna be bad because, you know, these first couple parts seem quite, you know, they're leading me into the game, and I just feel like it's a setup. I feel like at any moment now, I'm about to face an enemy that's extremely tough, and it's gonna make me regret everything.
There's only a limited amount of amrita we can extract from this country, Kelly.
Indeed, the pirates have served their purpose.
The death of the leader of Japan will spark a war and a wonderful opportunity to acquire more amrita.
Once tomorrow's execution takes place, we will get our hands on a compass that will lead us to that amrita.
With enough amrita, we could subdue Spain, perhaps even the world.
The day when England reigns supreme is near.
But our beloved queen thinks of Amrita as nothing more than gold or gemstones.
We must find them before our nation's rivals do.
Edward Kelly, you will go to Japan. It seems it would be to our advantage to keep the wars alive. We cannot gain Amrita
if blood does not flow.
Okay, so a little bit more about the stones.
Hey, who are you? Ooh,
this guy came out of nowhere. Now, I think that feature right there that you just seen my screen highlight is kind of the little kind of spider sense thing that I read about in a lot of the reviews. Whenever you aggro any of the guards or any of the enemies, you kind of get that little spider sense thing. So I'm assuming that's what that was. So it's a lot of places to explore here. I know I'm missing something. I don't want to miss anything. Probably gonna end this first video really soon. Don't want it to run too long. Just so I can also take a breather and maybe set up my I can fall down there, huh? Maybe set up my class a little bit. Well, not my class, but my shortcuts and things like that. And then continue from there. Can I pause it? I don't think so. Alright, well, let's keep going for a little bit. I just don't want to reach a big cutscene and not be able to capture it. Am I going back the opposite way? Oh. No pressing A. I'm digging it so far. If you like, you know, Dark Souls and things like that. Oh, okay, I see I'm behind the wall now that I was trying to open. That's cool. That's where I prayed at. Should I pray again? Is praying like saving? Somebody let me know. Let me know down in the comments. Maybe I'll find out later. I don't know. Does that make all the enemies come back? Yep, it sure does. I was not even thinking. It didn't even tell me anything. It didn't even say, hey, it's gonna make the enemies come back. But I'm thinking also that maybe it's close like that because I'm about to fight a boss. That's usually how the Souls games go and the Blood games go. You get like a little shortcut right before you get to a boss. So I'm assuming that's what's getting ready to happen. Alright, I'm back with part two of my Neo walkthrough. Hopefully I'm saying that right or pronouncing it correctly. Properly. Maybe I should keep going down because I wasn't on this side of the tower before. So maybe it's something good down here for me. This is pure darkness. Let's see. Am I back in the dungeon? Okay, we got a chest. That's always good. What else you got me? A coat? I'll take it. It gets cold in London sometime. Oh, we're outside. Or maybe I should have kept going up. This looks like the proper way to go. What's over here? Oh, another guard. He's just over here. Oh, look at that. It's three of them. Fuck that, dude. Should I try? Or should I just escape? Is there anything over there? Ah. Let's do it. Why not? Why not? That's why you get the game. Please. Not today. Look at this guy, kind of just oblivious to what's going on. He's like, he's just out of it. He's just ready to go home. He's like, you know, looking at his lantern. Yeah, buddy. Tired. That's another thing that I'm liking right now, that the other people get tired. I love their animations for it also. Liking the feel. I love how quick he moves. I love how responsive the controllers are right now. Oh, this guy. Oh, what was that? Was he just weak, or is that just a strong move? I don't know. What do we got? Another bastard sword? Some medicine? Some gloves? I wonder if there's anywhere to sell this stuff at, or anywhere, anything I can do with this duplicate, all this duplicate items that I'm getting. Alright, I want to see, you know, I just got to cover all my bases. Especially when you're playing games like this, there's a lot of little nooks and crannies you want to check out. So it looks like that's where I'm supposed to go. So I'm going to go all the way back up and see. Let's see what's up here since I'm on a different part of... I'm in a different part of the castle. I almost pressed O again. I'm trying to dodge. Again, thinking I'm playing, you know, Bloodborne. What does this guy give me? Stone? I'm assuming the stone is just like a pebble. Okay, so I've been in there. Okay. And there's no... I can't go any higher. Alright, let's get out of here then. Let's get out of this terrible place. Alright. I also like how kind of have all your equipment on you. Sometimes I feel like it's silly if a guy has like 1,000 friggy, has like a, you know, I've seen video clips where he has like a bow on his back and a staff and like 3 swords, and it's just, he's like a walking armory sometimes. But I do like that your items are represented on the actual character. That's not a bad look. As far as the graphics goes, they're all right for a game like this. I mean, it's not bad, but I mean, there's nothing to write home about either. But it doesn't take away from the experience at all. You know, you play these games for the gameplay aspect. That's what they're made for. But it certainly isn't a bad looking game. You see some of the weather effects there. You know, Rain always kind of had this thing where it made dance pretty good. And I backed up a little bit because my weapon was hitting the gate. I guess we could try out the battle axe also. Why not, right? Let's try out the battle axe. We tried out the bastard sword. We tried out, the Roomka. Now let's try the battle axe. Oh, see, this is what I'm saying. So now he even has the battle axe on his back, man. You see that? Yeah, whatever you put in your shortcut, it's gonna be on your back. This guy's a strong back, but we saw already he's been lifting his weights and you know, doing his push-ups and sit-ups. He's a pretty ripped guy. And he's a seller. Little fun fact, if you did not know, his character is based on a real life character. And he looks nothing like this guy. I mean, they kind of have the same beard, but they don't look alike. And I doubt the real life character was this big, but who cares? Are those guards right there? They look pretty tough. I don't know if I'm gonna mess with them. There does look like there's a crate over there. I mean, what the hell, right? Let's see if we can at least get this crate over here. I don't know how this video is coming out on YouTube. It might be kind of dark. It's dark on my TV, so I hear a lot of people complain about their capture devices bringing out things, making things a little bit darker. So if it is dark, let me know. I'll also
watch it and see, but let me know if it is dark. Let me know in the comments so I can try to brighten it. We'll go from there. Those guys didn't mess with me. I'm okay with that. I'm not going to mess with them either. I'm picking up a lot of stuff and trying to wonder if I'm going to become over encumbered. I wonder if there is a... I guess there's no sneak attack button, kind of like Souls game. We get the animation. One thing I am liking right now, he does move a little bit slower when you're carrying a heavy weapon, but it's nothing too drastic. I'm assuming that will change once I put on heavier gear. I do plan on...
Looks like I might be able to escape from the top of that tower. How can I get up there?
Top of the tower? What tower? I do plan on playing a more heavy based character. Heavy damage, things like that. Simply because in most of the Souls and the Bloodborne games, I usually play a quicker character. Because, you know, you have to be able to roll in those games and get out of the way. But if I'm still able to roll and move fast and then deal out big damage, oh, then hell yeah. I'm definitely going to be using heavy weapons, you know. This guy here looks pretty tough. Check my shot. Okay, perfect. We're going to aggro this guy. Try to take on one at a time. He has a battle axe, too. Oh, I'm glad I can interrupt his attack, because if not, I would have hurt him. I like the magic, man. Oi, move. Oi. So, that guy's hit took a lot of... Oh, he rolls too. Took a lot of my... I don't know. Did I get both of them? No, this guy's still up. All right. Oh, so I do not want to block that because it will take all of my stamina. I do like the dodging mechanic. And you know, guys, I can be pretty petty sometimes. I'll admit to that. Oh, that's funny. You fell down. I wonder if there's an animation that I can hit while they're down, or what exactly it is. But I was gonna say I can be really petty sometimes, and when I see things like, you know, rolling is a big thing in games, rolling out of the way. But I like to see the actual dodge mechanic, just like the quick step, move out of the way. I like that a lot better than rolling, because I think, like, when you're in combat, you don't want to roll on the ground. I mean, unless you're, like, diving out of the way of, like, a grenade or something crazy like that. But when you're fighting, I don't think you want to leave your feet purposely, at least not in a, you know, when you're carrying weapons and things like that. So I do like to see the actual quick step mechanic. Now there is like a little backflip that he does there, but that's just to create a little bit more space. And I like that. It just, for me, it enhances the experience. It's kind of like the same thing with graphics. Graphics don't make or kill a game, but when you have them, it enhances it. It makes it a lot better. And that's how I feel about some things like that. So I picked up a breastplate. It's gonna give me a lot more armor. So let's see if it makes me move slower. I see damage reduction. I don't see anything where it tells me if I'm gonna move slower. Oh wait, equipment weight, I see it up there. Okay. Breastplate, 43%. It turns green, so I'm assuming I'm gonna move a little bit slower. Let's see. Alright, still pretty fast. I don't, you know, nothing too noticeable. And I wonder. Oi, behind me. Oh, and that guy could have ended me. He's just a little bit slow. He's just a little bit slow. Out of the way. So I can get my camera working so you guys can see the intensity on my face right now. I'm trying to dodge these guys because it's just the psychological factor of the game. You know that if you mess up, you're probably dead, and I think that's the beautiful thing about it. Oh, I'm stuck, and there we go. My first death. I was trying to make it through without dying on this first run. I was really trying. At least to get out of the prison. But I got stuck, man. I got stuck on, and I couldn't even see it. That's the crazy part. I could not see it. And it was too late when I realized what happened. So they're gonna start me right back at it. That's okay. I think I went all the way down to where I need to go. Oh, that's a bummer. I didn't want to die so early. Not on the training stage. Never want to down the training stage. Especially me, when I consider myself such a great gamer. I don't know if I got this one before. Probably not. But yeah, just not being aware of my surroundings. Now, it looks like I had my medicine in the quick slot, and I don't see it anymore. Is that because I pressed something? Did I press something? Okay, I'm assuming that I have to do something to pick myself up or I don't know. But my medicine isn't there. I'm gonna try again and see if I can do like a... No? Okay. Kind of just going crazy right now. Which is what you don't want to do. Oh, I could have went up there. Where did that guy at? Died in here somewhere, right? Alright, let's draw this guy out again. Boy, he almost got me. Good thing I didn't use all my stamina. Oh man, I'm getting out of hand now. I gotta calm down. I keep thinking he's gonna come back around with that battle axe. Okay, I see what I did. Okay, so you can change the accessory slot, basically. Intruder! Holding block stops my stamina from regenerating. Okay. Alright, let's try this again. I think this is... Where I was at last time.
I saw it!
Oh, my time.
No way.
Should have finished him. And extra tosses. Bing, extra tosses again. Never want to keep going. Not too far. Got yourself to a corner like I did last time. Dodging for no reason. Oh, that was bad. That was bad. And I'm stuck on the same thing again. Alright, that was good. That was good. Let's see what it was worth. Probably nothing. So some heavier armor, basically. And I'm gonna go ahead and equip it. And let's see how much it actually changes my characteristics. These gloves are actually a little bit stronger. Okay. Whatever. Freeze. Okay, so now I'm at 73%. Oh, I do have helm on me. If I can cover up that face. Yeah, he does move. He's starting to move significantly slower. Yeah, that roll isn't that great. Okay. So yeah, they are gonna penalize you for the weight reduction. That's pretty good. So let's see how I do with that. Oh, another place to pray. Guess that's gonna make everybody come back. That's all right. Should I go down? What's down here? This first level is pretty big, man. It's a lot of stuff to look at. I have like two videos of just one level.
Using monsters like that to fight wars. Guess they got no more use for us.
I feel like this is a trap.
Could he just split in two?
Striking when the opponent is down and helpless. That's what they're trying to do to all of us who fought for queen and country.
Okay. So I was wondering on my last video, was there a way to hit them while they're down? I guess that's it. Triangle. Alright, let's go up and see if we can get out of here before this video ends. So that I don't have three videos of the same level. And, got some more guards here. We're gonna go ahead and just go up, man. I don't think I need to fight, though. Let's just go up and try to get out of here.
Damn! Made it all this way for nothing?
Well, I'm gonna do
something. If I jump...
I don't see nobody. There we are. Okay. I'm gonna have to brighten this up a little bit more. Oh, there you go. Now you wanna help me. Oh, that doesn't sound good. Derek the Executioner, let's go. I ran out of stamina really fast. So what it's looking like is your armor is gonna weigh down on your stamina too, or how much it takes when you dodge.
Ah,
It's you.
I do like that.
The man with the guardian spirit.
If I die, the secret of the stones dies with me.
Let me show you what these stones can do. Behold.
Yeah, I knew killing that guy was too easy.
It's time for your execution.
Yep, I knew that was too easy. Might have to take some of this shit off. Okay, I'm just gonna take it easy now. Not sure I died, but okay. Take that mask off so I can see his expressions.
All right, so I'm gonna end this first video right there, and then we'll start right back up with part three of our Neo walkthrough. Or maybe we won't. Maybe we'll wait till the end of this cutscene.
Journey was not an enjoyable one. During 2 years' voyage, the Hellof was lost. The Trow sank, while the Hope vanished without a trace. The good news of the Blider Boatshap was nothing but lies. Only Leifda remained. Ironic twist. For what awaited us in the Far East wasn't love. It was monsters and death.
Ah, so this is the beginning. Okay. They gave us the old James Bond start. That's cool. I'm not mad at it.